So, hello, welcome back again. So, today we are going to do something weirder, in a way. I always say that, I'm not sure why. But I'm going to show you a little bit about what the small studio we created now looks like. So, let me first put myself a little bit into the picture somewhere. Myself over there. And I will showcase a little bit of different parts. Some parts I've already shown. But now it's kind of fully done, and I think there are several parts which are quite interesting for some of you to also play with yourself. So I figured it was good to give you a small overview. My goal was always to create a small setup that I can use to review parts, but also that I can take with me either complete or parts of it. And I didn't want to use a computer, to be fair. I know that OBS can do many of these things I'm showing. But I wanted to, let's say, keep it smaller and more practical in a way. And also, theoretically, most of this could fit in one bag and I can take with me when I'm doing a project. So first thing, let me give you a quick overview of what's on the table. And then we will zoom into different parts to get you some ideas and also what I will be reviewing next. I know that the output, like the green screen I'm doing now, is not perfect. Luckily, I'm quite small in the corner, so that doesn't matter too much. But it also means that I'm still learning and I didn't set everything up correctly or put it in its default position. So next to me, you see a camera. So let me, for a second, put myself on full screen. You can see a camera, which I'm going to use, unlike the last time where people were complaining I was moving all over the place. I will try to at least keep it a little bit stable when we zoom into the different parts. So that is already an improvement. And the idea here is that you get a little bit of an idea of what we are doing. Some parts are optional. I will talk about it when they're optional. They only give you extra features or more control, easier controls. Let's get going. So the core of the system at the moment is this quite old, because it's already 4 years old, video switcher. The sound is now pretty okay, I hope, but it is making a lot of noise. I'm trying to fix that. I might hack it open and fix it later. But basically, it's an HDMI-based video switcher that you can buy for about $1,000. So you can see it's not too big. And you can hook up 4 HDMIs and do quite a lot of effects, like I just showed you, with a fader, with a T-bar, control things. I can move, for example, if I use this effect, I can move myself using one of the buttons and place myself in any corner. I do cool, all kinds of effects. It has 4 HDMI ins, which I'm using all at the moment. I will showcase what I've got on there. And you can optionally, you can also see that on the left, add an iPad application so that you get a little bit more control. So for example, we now only see audio coming in from the mic input. Let me zoom in so that you can see that a little bit better. So you can see that there's only audio coming in from one of the inputs. But let me just, for the fun of it, also open up this camera, which is camera number 1. So if I decide, and sorry if I'm bending over all the time, let me turn myself off. If I turn this one on, you can see, you might hear a weird echo, but you can see that now the audio from this camera also comes in. I can basically do that with any of the video inputs that I have. And you can mix it all together, which you can do without the iPad, but it just makes it easier to control everything. The same with all the effects that you can do it on it, so it's easier to control. And the app has multiple pages. So for example, you can also, let me tiny bit so that the glare is gone. You can also switch it if I press it like this, or let for a second go to the in screen again. But I will switch only the small overlay. You can see that if I push it, the iPad automatically follows. But I can also use, of course, the on-screen tools to turn things around, right? So it's quite nice, and I think a good setup. So next to it, what you see, let me zoom in, which is quite, I would say a default part, quite a default part. You can see on the table, a small Rode receiver. You can use any, there's basically a headphone output here and a mic output here on the side. I'm now using the mic input, which gives you a little bit more control, but I use at the moment the Rode video kit because I just hooked myself up using a left microphone and I can run away without taking the whole equipment bar with me, which is not a good idea. There's many options in this video switcher. I think it's a good alternative if you like to have the buttons and that you can play, can press it without basically people noticing it. I prefer it over using a laptop so far. So let me zoom in a little bit to the left. Oops, so here we go. You see that the four HDMI cables are coming out. There's a little bit more than four. Sometimes, which I think is very handy, I use these extenders so that I don't have to plug them in at the back, but I can actually plug them into the extenders. So in this case, what you are seeing, and let me put that one into the lower picture, which is number two. It was not number two, it was number three. You see the small one in the image. This is actually a complete computer. So it's called an Intel USB stick. And the nice thing about it is now running our application. So if I switch it around, so make that one big and the other one small, you can see that this is an application. So while I'm testing with people and they are playing this game, this one is about the famous painting Night Watch, and you can control this using your phone. And so this is just an example that I can run on this computer, but I could also use it just as a background effect if I'm doing green keying on the big screen. So if I want to do it on this, so if I want to use, let's say, the top camera, is it? Top camera, I could green screen on this and then use that little computer as an overlay for that. So that's quite nice. So that was that. So next to that, and I kind of, maybe it looks in a weird position, but well, let me first zoom into that one, because that's actually kind of an interesting little box. You can see the small box over there, I hope. So this one, it's a USB stick on it. It's actually the one that I'm now using to stream to YouTube. Let me see if I'm actually streaming. Yep, I am actually streaming to YouTube. So let me also put myself back in the lower corner. The nice thing about this is that you can power it over USB, so you can even take it with you. It has Wi-Fi and Ethernet. I already did a review on it, so look on my channel if you want to see how it works. But it's now basically sending it to YouTube, and YouTube will then automatically, once I hit I'm done, put the whole thing online, which is what I wanted. So you can see there's a green button. If I press the green button, we start streaming to YouTube. If I press the green button again, it will stop. The red button is actually also nice. It can do an internal recording, only 1 megabit, which is a little bit low, but well, you can actually tune it a little bit. But on the USB stick, you can actually, if you hit the red button, also use that. Now, the nice thing about it, you can use it directly on the box. And what's really nice, by the way, the box has also an HDMI in, but also an HDMI out, so you can actually loop it through, which is interesting when you're going to see the next part of the setup. For that, I need to zoom a little bit out, so you can see all of them at the same time. So what you see next, I knew this was going to be messy, but at least less messy than the last time I tried to show it. So you can see that there are three monitors. The lowest monitor is basically my output monitor. The output monitor, of course, is like any output monitor from a video table, but it loops back into this streaming box, and the streaming box then at the moment, the streaming box is actually going to another computer which is able to send it out over Skype. So just to be complete, I will put a drawing online, but basically the video mixer output goes to the lowest monitor, which is also a recorder, so it's an Atomos recorder. I could also record it on that, so that would be my high quality copy. Then the output from that goes into that little box which sends this to YouTube, but its output again goes to another computer that I can send over Skype to other people watching, or if I don't want to use YouTube but I want to use Skype, I can actually do that. So the middle monitor is my preview monitor, which makes perfect sense. So let's take myself out of the corner and just show you the preview. As you can see, is the red one, and the green one is the live. So if I switch, you can see we switch to one or the other. Of course, depending on which effect you use, you can do a fade or do a wipe or some other things. Normally put it on just on this one. You can do a fade. And you can see that I, for example, if you want to go to the top camera, which is number two, right? I can then fade to the top camera, go back, and then, of course, if I want to go to the painting, switch it back to the painting. I hope this makes perfect sense. You have also have two effect bars, which you can use to bring in myself again, and you can also set the size and some other stuff. I'm still a little bit of a cold, so I might still sneeze. Sorry for that. Now the top monitor, which I think you can see. Let me check by putting it in the screen, in the background, which is number one. So here we go. There it is. So the top monitor is actually also an iPhone. And that's basically controlling the little streaming box. You can also see, again, the red button and the green button. So the green button tells me that we are live, and I can actually look at it and I can see that we are now live for 12 minutes. So we're already getting to our magical 20 minutes or half an hour, which would be normal for me. It gives you some statistics about how well the connection is running. It's actually totally wireless, so it also makes for quite a nice sort of feedback monitor if you want to, even for the audio. So I could actually use this outside, and I've put a video online where basically the small box I just showed you, so the streaming box combined with the iPhone and a 4G connection running on the same iPhone, gives me a total portable setup just going into one of my cameras. I think I was using the A7 or the A6500 at that moment. So I don't want to press the green button because then everything will go off and we are done. So I will do that at the end. So let me zoom out a little bit further and move a bit up, because then you'll find actually two very interesting ones. Of course, in this case, that's why I normally would put, let's say, the subject, right? So you can see, in this case, I put an A7 R3 there. And on top of that, you'll find the, let me zoom into that one, you will find the camera which is actually doing the top view. So if, let's say, I want to put that one on, so the top view is number two. So let me put it on the small one. There you can see the top view and me putting my hand next to it. Now you can already see on this screen a very interesting one. So let me put it there, because that's actually my iPhone, which is my fourth camera. And why did I do that? So let me switch it back. No, that doesn't make any sense. Let me see if I can. Let me first turn the effect off, then go to that. So this is basically my green screen, right? So of course I have a green background there, and you can see that it's now giving me a clean output, right? Well, if I, let's go to a different effect and do it on split screen. That's hopefully not too confusing, but let me try to set that up quickly for you. Whoa, now you have two of Nimi, which kind of no sense, but and now switch this one to the one I wanted to show you. So you can see now next to each other, sorry for the distortion a little bit, but basically what I wanted to show you. So this one, this front iPhone XS in this case, just my iPhone, I hooked it up for power and to HDMI. And the nice thing about this application is that it gives me both a clean output, which of course is now going to the mixing table, but it also gives me a visual feedback so that I can watch myself and remember to look at the camera, of course, because the camera is of course in the phone itself, but it's also doing the green screen. So it's actually my fourth camera doing the green screen and providing both, if need be, both audio and video back cleanly to the outside. Now I will start playing with it so you can see how it kind of works, because I think that's one of the more interesting parts now of this setup. But it also means that the green screen will probably totally go haywire. So you can see now that I can decide, for example, how strong the green screen need to work. So let me pull the slider and you can see that actually the background now becomes blue. Well, it's green, which is a bit weird, but you can see that this determines the strength of the effect. I can also set the color. So if I put it in the wrong color, you can see, yes, background is green. You can do this totally automatically if you want to, but you can also you can quite quickly set it up yourself in not too bad way. Keep in mind, especially if I put it on the wrong color, you can see how badly my back screen is still is. I just put like a green $20 sort of cloth there. I will buy a really nice flat one in the future, so it becomes a little bit easier to do. Even now I found it quite easy to set up compared to the green screen application, which is also in the mixing table. So I still have that free, so if I want to use in the future the top camera, right? So not this one, but let me see, this one, I can also put a green screen over here. And since that the video mixer also has a green screen, but it's much less powerful than your iPhone, so the quality was just worse and you don't have as much control, but I could do two layers of green screen, which might turn out to be handy. Sorry if I get a bit confused now, because I have to reach over the camera to get to the mixing table. I could, of course, also didn't think about it, but taking my iPad and just hold it in my hand and switch it like that, or use my iPhone. So this is quite nice in this app. What is also nice, whoops, I find that the buttons are a little bit fiddly, to be fair, but you can do all kinds of extra things. It can record and do stuff like that. But this is an important button, and that I didn't see on other reviews of this application. I'll put a link in the description. It's $3. But this point, one is quite important, because this, again, provides a clean output to the mixing table. So if I press this button, you can see that it stops doing that. And you can now see that on the left side and the right side, you see both of the buttons pop up, which is not what we want. So the fact that this is live and it allows me to output a clean, whoops, there it goes. It allows me to put a clean effect over there. It's pretty cool. I can also record it, and there are some other features I didn't look at yet. What is also cool, of course, is you can change the background. So you can switch between the old and new ones. So let's assume I'm already traveling. You can see that I'm now nicely on sea, sort of, on my next cruise. Or what you can do is put your own picture there. So I use this one several times. Now you can already see a little bit of this noise, because I didn't set up the green screen correctly. I filled a little bit too much with the previous one. But they provide you with a few examples, and you can upload your own movies. So you can hit add, and then I can even do add here, and then it goes to all. So I think they provide you with background. So if you want to have like a famous the Hollywood sign in the background. Is it Hollywood background? You can place it as you can see, and then it becomes part of your collection. I'm not sure if it does that now live. Press this one and then. So of course you can see that you have to fiddle a little bit. Let me improve this a little bit. Setup. Sometimes I don't understand the input. Oops. That one. Color a bit. That to it off. And the strength. Of course, this is what you do before you go and do your effect. But you can see now it's set up again. That is not too bad, right? The colors are a bit off and there's all kinds of other things wrong with it. But you can see that this again gives me a clean output. So if I go back to the full view, we now have the Hollywood sign in the background. Of course, I should probably have zoomed it out, but oh well. Maybe they won't zoom me now because I'm not sure. Let's zoom over this image. This is kind of the setup. Maybe show you one more thing, which I think you already have seen before. Let me first reprogram this, that this does become, I don't think it's okay. Keep it like this. So you've seen me squashed anyway. So let me zoom out a little bit more, because what you do see, and that's going to be difficult to show you, but I've showed that before, that on the table, you see that I've created this $15 to $20 sort of clothing rack. There's a special review on it. And on top of that, I've attached four lights at the moment. In the future, they will all be aiming at the table, because I will put different lights on the green screen. But for now, and this is probably not a very bad idea, you can see that that light, one over there, is now actually aiming at the green screen and providing light for that. So yeah, that's kind of the setup at the moment. So yeah, I think if there's more questions about this, I'm more than willing to do a live session. But I think this application is probably going to I wouldn't say the star of the day, but that's quite a kind of a nice application to see, because it has so many features and it actually solves a very interesting problem for little money. So yeah, this is probably the end of this video. So this was a quick overview of my current setup. And as you can see, I think it's quite complete. Well, the last thing I guess I can show you, let me find a nice angle for that one. It has to be that one. So you can see that there's some free HDMI plugs over there. So sometimes if I need to, let me turn this weird effect off. So sometimes if I need to plug something else in, so for the last few videos, for example, I had to plug in my laptop, I can quickly change one of the inputs, because the mixing table is only four channels, which I think is already more than enough. But I might put a small HDMI switching box over here to have a little bit more plugs available. But this is kind of my new small little setup that I can use both for Skype, which I didn't do it on YouTube yet, but I did already test. So one of the things that I can also do is, because the last streaming box sends it out to Skype, and Skype can also send its signal back, I can actually do an interview or do a session with people on Skype and bring them into the whole system. So I think, given the, let's say the size, because if I all put it together, you can put it probably in about 40 by, switch to myself again. I think you could probably put it in about 40 by 40 centimeters. I'm not sure, that's probably 1 feet by 1 feet or something, if you want to. And again, some of the parts are optional. So the iPad is actually optional. So this one is kind of optional. The one on top. So That one is kind of optional because you can just use the buttons on the box and trust it. Or you can actually switch live, right? So what you can do, which I've done before, is use your iPhone both as your control, or the iPad would be easier. You use your iPad both to control the little box, and you can control the mixing table, and you can swipe between them, and that actually kind of works. So you can see how I could. That's why I built the little stack like that. I can put it in a big suitcase, put some, of course, some parts I will take apart, put it all in a big suitcase, and you kind of have a whole little studio with you. So yeah, hopefully you found some parts that you have more questions about. Just ask me. I will try to put all the products in the description. But for now, this is probably going to be the end of the video. Let me quickly check how long it is. It's below half an hour, so that's good. 26 minutes for the people who made it this far. Thanks for watching, and if you have questions, just ask. Keep in mind that I for sure didn't set this up in the best way, especially the green screening and some of the other effects. I know it can be done better, but this is sort of my current state of affairs. So I figured it was a good moment to give you an update and give you some ideas on how you can also do it if you don't want to use something like OBS, for example. Oh, before I forget, this box, which the streaming box, there is a longer review about it, but you can do it to YouTube and Twitch and some other places. It's quite a complete sort of setup. So see you in the next one, and bye bye, and I will try to turn you to black without looking to it. Yeah, there we go. Bye-bye.